Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode here on African Confessions. The following story that you're going to be listening to, it comes from a translation of a message that I received. The translation of that message reads like this. Hello, how are you? I want to confess that I bewitched my neighbor's son so that he can fail his exams because my own child could not pass. This happened last year, and I want to confess that I was using witchcraft to make sure that this young boy that was very intelligent will never pass the examinations ever again in his life. And I truly never imagined that I would go this far, because me and my neighbor, we used to be very close, but I did something that is terrible, something that I can't take back, that is going to affect this young boy for the rest of his life. All because of jealousy. Out of jealousy, I used witchcraft to curse my neighbor's son, whom I'll call Sihle, not his real name, so that he would fail his exams. I did not do it because of anything that the mother did to me. I did it because I just felt like, since my child was failing school over and over again, it was like embarrassing for me. I don't know if people were laughing at me, but I just thought that maybe people would be laughing at me. Now, it is really like bad what this young man is doing. It all began when the exams results were announced. My son, whom I'll call Temba, was sitting for his final school exams, and like any other mother, I had high hopes. I had prayed for him, pushed him to study, even borrowed money for extra lessons. I told myself that this was going to be his moment to shine, the moment that he would prove to everyone that he was capable. But when the results came out, my heart was shattered, for my son had failed each and every single subject, and I could not believe it. I had watched my son study throughout the night. My son was not giving himself any rest at all. He was focused, for he wanted to achieve his goals, and I would pray with him. That is why I turned to witchcraft, because I said, if God is not faithful enough to help my son when he had tried to work like this, so what is it good for me to pray with my son anymore? It is far much better that I find someone who can assist me. In my mind, what I was telling myself, if I could steal my neighbor's son's brain and then give them to my own son, thinking that maybe it was going to make the situation to be better. But what I've discovered about witchcraft is that you get in there thinking that you are solving a problem, but you create more problems, and you need more witchcraft to solve the problems that you'll be facing. That is the case right now. And what I have discovered about witchcraft, especially witchcraft that happens between neighbors, your neighbor, when you bewitch them, your neighbor doesn't have to give you like a very big reason for you to bewitch them. It just happened out of pure hatred and jealousy. And one who is not your relative will never become your relative, no matter how close they might seem to be to you. That is what was going on between me and my friend. She would be happy that her son had achieved, had passed, but my son had failed. So I felt like maybe she was looking down upon me. That was when I went and I consulted. I consulted with this other Sangoma who comes from another location. Like, I had to take 3 taxes to show you that I really wanted to bewitch my neighbor's son. I went to town, then got into another taxi, then got into a location where I got the taxi that was going to the place where I was going to get this Sangoma. This Sangoma, she was a woman. She took me to this other shack at the back of her house, which she uses as a consultation room. Whilst we were there, that was when we started talking, and I was honest with her, and I told her that all that I wanted, I really wanted my neighbor to suffer. I did not want my neighbor's son to go ahead with his education and studies. And then the Sangoma told me that all that was needed was for me to go and buy 2 eggs. So I went to these other spaza shops and I bought 2 eggs. And then when I arrived, I saw that this Sangoma had taken out this other idol that was made out of wood and made me to smash those eggs on the head of that idol. And that is what I did. After I had smashed those 2 eggs on the head of that idol, then I was told that what was going to happen was that my neighbor's son was going to lose his mind. And when I returned back, I was told that even though I had congratulated my neighbor and her son, I had to go and do it again. When I got there, as I was speaking with her, she was even surprised because I had been there when I heard that his son had passed the exams that he had wrote. So I returned back to her home and she just looked at me and she said, you are getting old. And I say, what do you mean when you say that I am getting old? And she was like, you know, you came here, and when you came here, you congratulated me and my son. Have you forgotten? She even showed me the video that we had taken whilst we were both celebrated. And I said, it means I am growing old, because I had totally forgotten that I came to your house. That is how I pretended, even though I knew that this was part of the ritual that I was fulfilling. After a couple of days, that was when she came to our house. When she came to our house, then she said that her son was not okay and she wanted to go to the clinic, and they were asking for us to help them since we have a car. And then I spoke with my husband, and my husband said it is okay. We then went with them, Brother Nashi, to the clinic, and then we were referred to the hospital. So I spoke with my husband, and my husband told me that it is okay. We then went to the hospital, where she was told that my neighbor's son was not okay, was then taken to the psychiatric ward. Ever since that day, my neighbor's son is totally crazy. Like, even the things that he can say, you can just see that this one is running mad. But I made the situation to be worse. Whilst we were taking him to the psychiatric ward, it was very lucky of me that when he was telling his mom everything that was going on, because he was pointing at me, since he was being held by two nurses, they did not allow him to say what was on his mind. But I heard him saying that it is Mom Kumalo, not her own name, who is making me to run mad. She used her charms on me because I passed my exams. They quickly took him away, and I ran back to that sangoma and told the sangoma everything that had happened whilst we were at the hospital. She said, no worries, do not worry. That was when we made sure that the way that he was going to run mad, he won't even remember his name. Like, now he is more like a zombie, walks around the location. He is not helpful at all. He is just a madman. But it gives me great pain knowing that he is going to be like this for the rest of his life. I am really sorry for what I did, and at the same time, I am scared of confessing to my neighbor, for I do not know what other steps she is going to take. Dear listeners, right there was a message that was sent to me by one of our admin who helped us with this translation.